Yeah. welcome to our Good Friday service. This is a tenebrae service. Tenebrae means shadows. So this is a service of shadows. That's why our lights are dimmed. And this is different from Advent, where we light another candle. We will be extinguishing the candles as we read throughout the Passion narrative this evening. We will stand at the very beginning of the service, but during the hymns that we sing between the Passion songs, or the Passion narratives, will stay seated at that point. But let us rise as you are able and call ourselves to the worship of God. On this Good Friday, we contemplate the good news of the cross. How Christ our Lord stretched out his arms to embrace a world of suffering and sin. How Christ our Lord stretched out his arms to save us. Our opening hymn is number 216, Beneath the Cross of Jesus.
Holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have
but you led me to the judgment hall of Pilate. I guided you by the light of the Holy Spirit, but you made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and mortal one, have mercy upon us. I planted you as my fairest vineyard, but you brought forth bitter fruit. I made you branches of the vine and never left your side. But you have made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. I poured out saving water from the rock, but you gave me vinegar to drink. I poured out my life and gave you the new covenant in my blood. But you have made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us. I gave you a royal scepter, but you have given me a crown of thorns. I gave you the kingdom and crowned you with eternal life, but you have made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. I struck down your enemies, but you struck my head with a reed. I gave you my peace, but you drew the sword in my name. And you have made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. I opened the waters and led you to the promised land, but you opened my side with a spear. I washed your feet as a sign of love, but you have made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us. I lifted you up to the heights, but you lifted me high on the cross. I raised you from death and prepared for you the tree of life, but you have made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us. I grafted you into my people Israel, but you made them scapegoats for your own guilt, and you have made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us. I was hungry, and you gave me no food. Thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not clothe me. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit me. And you have made a cross for your Savior. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal one, have mercy upon us. Hear the good news. This is the new covenant I make with you, says the Lord. I will put my law in your hearts. I will remember your sin no more. Beloved, believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven.
Shadow of betrayal from the Gospel of 10 through 13 and 16 through 21. Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. When they heard it, they were greatly pleased and promised to give him money. So he began to look for an opportunity to betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb was sacrificed, his disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and make the preparedness for you to eat Passover?" So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him." So the disciples set out and went to the city and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he came with the 12, and when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me." They began to be distressed and to say to him one after another, "Surely not I." He said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born."
Shadow of the agony of the spirit and the rest. The reading is from Luke 22:39-48. He came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. When he reached the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not come into the time of trial." Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down and prayed, "Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done." Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling on the ground. When he got up from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping because of grief. And he said to them, "Why are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you may not come into the time of trial." While he was still speaking, suddenly a crowd came, and the one called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He approached Jesus to kiss him, but Jesus said to him, "Judas, is it with a kiss that you are betraying the Son of Man?"
The shadow of denial. From the Gospel of Luke, continuing, verses 54 to 62. Then they seized Jesus and led him away, bringing him into the high priest's house. But Peter was following at a distance. When they had kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat among them. Then a servant girl, seeing him in the firelight, stared at him and said, "This man also was with him." But he denied it, saying, "Woman, I do not know him." A little later, someone else, on seeing him, said, "You also are one of them." But Peter said, "Man, I am not." Then about an hour later, still another kept insisting, "Surely this man also was with him, for he is a Galilean." But Peter said, "Man, I do not know what you are talking about." At that moment, while he was still speaking, the cock crowed. The Lord turned and looked at Peter. Then Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will deny me three times." Peter went out and wept bitterly.
So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?" For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas and for them instead. Pilate spoke to them again, "Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call the king of the Jews?" They shouted back, "Crucify him." Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified.
Thank you. shadow of mockery, reading from Matthew 27, verses 27 to 31. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the governor's headquarters, and they gathered the whole cohort around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on his head. They put a reed in his right hand and knelt before him and mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They spat on him and took the reed and struck him on the head. After mocking him, they stripped him of the robe and put on his own clothes again. Then they led him away to crucify him.
The Shadow of Crucifixion, from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 23, verses 32 through 43. Two others also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with him. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing, and the people stood by, watching. But the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds, but this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise."
Thank you.
shadow of death. When it was noon, darkness came over the whole world, the whole land, until 3 p.m. At 3:00, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he's calling for Elijah." And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down." Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion, who stood facing him, saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly this man was God's son."
Nicodemus, who had first come to Jesus by night, also came, bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, weighing about 100 pounds. They took the body of Jesus and wrapped it with the spices in a linen cloth, according to the burial custom of the Jews. Now there was a garden in the place where he was crucified, and in the garden there was a new tomb, in which no one had ever been laid. And so, because it was the day of preparation, and the tomb was nearby, they laid Jesus there.
Thank you.
beloved people of God. As Jesus stretched out his arms on the cross to offer life and salvation to all, let us pray for the world that God loves so much. We pray for the church throughout the world. Almighty and eternal God, you have shown your glory to all the nations in Jesus Christ. By your Holy Spirit, guide your church and gather it throughout the world. Help it to persevere in faith, proclaim your name, and bring the good news of salvation in Christ to all people. We pray for the John Knox Presbytery and the congregation of Union Presbyterian Church. Your Spirit guides the church and makes it holy. Strengthen and uphold all church leaders. Keep them in health and safety for the good of the church. Help each of us to do faithfully the work which you have called us to. We pray for the people of other faiths. Gather into your embrace all those who call out to you under different names. Bring an end to interreligious strife, and make us more faithful in our witness to the love made known to us in your Son. We pray for those who cannot believe. You created humanity so that all might long to know you and find peace in you. Grant that all may recognize signs of your love and grace in the world and in the lives of Christians, and yet gladly acknowledge you as the one true God. We pray for creation. You are the creator of a magnificent universe. Hold this world in the arms of your care. Heal the damage we have done, and bring all things to fulfillment in you. We pray for the leaders and people of all nations. You are the champion of the poor and the oppressed. In your goodness, give wisdom to those in authority so that people everywhere may enjoy justice, peace, freedom, and share in the goodness of your creation. We pray for all who suffer or are in need. Give strength to the weary and new courage to those who have lost heart. Hear the prayers of all who call on you in any trouble, that they may have the joy of receiving your help in their need. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And as our Savior taught us, we are bold to pray in the words closest to our hearts. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.